Hello there, my good viewers. Welcome to another installment of Pokemon of the Week. Now, unfortunately, I still haven't gotten around to doing the screen boards for the requested list. So again, this week, this will be a Pokemon that I'm going to review of my own choosing. So this week's Pokemon of the Week is going to be going to Ariados. I thought I'd do Ariados because it's a very underlooked Pokemon. It's very rarely actually taken into consideration for any team. So I thought might as well give it a little bit of spotlight. So on appearance, this thing isn't exactly amazing. It's decent, I guess. It does make sense, given the fact that it's based more for spider-ish. I think it's based off a spider, for that matter. But overall, it's decent on appearance. Nothing really wrong with it, but can't say I love this thing. So, moving into the stats page now. Now, first off, it's not very good at defending. Even though it's got a decent in-base HP, its defense and special defense aren't really that noteworthy. Its defense isn't horribly bad. It could probably take a neutral hit, maybe, from a not very strong Pokemon in offense, if attack or special attack, but, you know, sorry, attack, beg your pardon. But, you know, overall, it's not going to be taking hits amazingly well, sadly. And its speed, now, the speed really does bother me, big time, given the fact that, well, if it's based off a spider, or whatever, it's supposed to be pretty fast. And if you see this Pokemon in PBR, or Pokemon Colosseum, it actually looks pretty swift, it moves around quite fast. So, for that reason, I'm amazed that it's got such a low base speed. I mean, I suppose it could be its back end, so to say, is a bit on the big side, but it's not exactly really, really big. It's actually quite small compared to some other stuff. So for that reason, I thought it'd be quite fast, at least 300 in speed, but it's actually not good in speed at all. It's not even worth maxing the speed out because it just isn't good enough. So attack is pretty much the only stat it's got that's noteworthy, really, but again, not really majorly high, so probably the main reason why this Pokemon is overlooked a lot of the time. Alright then, so taking a look at the abilities first in the uses section. Now, out of the three abilities, I have to say that I think Insomnia is the best ability, as that prevents you from being able to put Ariados to sleep, which is useful against the likes of Hypnosis users, or even better, Spore users, so that's quite useful. Sniper is usable, it basically gives you triple the damage on critical hits instead of double the damage, which is useful, I guess, but I don't think it's as useful as the other two. Swarm can possibly be used, but because of its low base speed, it can't exactly be utilized to its full potential. So if you want my honest advice, go with Insomnia, but you can try Swarm if you really want to. Now, I've made a slight mistake here on the weaknesses, I'm afraid. Yeah, the ground weakness is actually a mistake. I don't know why I put ground down. Excuse me. I do apologize for making that stupid mistake. I don't know why I put ground down, because I forgot that, I guess I forgot the bugs actually resist ground. So yeah, ignore the ground weakness, that's a mistake on my part. But the flying, fire and psychic, well, they're not that bad really. I can't really complain. Yeah, the psychic is to be expected given the fact that it's part poison. Flying and fire, well, they're weaknesses to bugs in general, so we're not going to complain that much. The resistances on the other hand are actually not that bad. It's 4 times resistant to grass because of it being a bug poison type. Fighting resistance is actually very useful because that actually means if you've got a Pokemon like Tyranitar, for instance, who we actually reviewed last week, then you can bring your Ariados in and take the fighting type attack really nicely. Poison isn't really that big of a deal because poison isn't used that much offensively by default, but it's still handy to have right there. And of course, bug. Bug is used not very commonly, but it is common within certain Pokemon such as Volcarona and Heracross and Pokemon like that. Now, unfortunately, because of the rather bad area of stats, it's not very notable in what physical or support moves it can learn. Now, fortunately, it does learn Sucker Punch, which does work around, sort of, the speed problem. And Shadow Sneak is also good for getting priority in. And, of course, Poison Jab is useful because it's Stab, as is Bug Bite. You know, but again, a common problem we get a lot of the Pokemon here is the physical side is completely walled by Steel types. Yeah, you'd think by now that our good friends at Game Freak, will actually have made more Pokemon given a move that actually works on steel types. But no, they insist on keeping these lower down Pokemon with no move to hit steel types with, which is a shame. Now, support may at first seem like a bit of a silly thing, given the fact that it's not got very good speed, but as always, we always point out that if a Pokemon has low base speed, it means it can be used on Trick Room, and it does have a decent amount of moves to choose from. Now, Agility can be used, but it's not extremely effective. Yeah, if you're running, say, a neutral nature for speed, then you're looking at around 150 on speed, which doubles with agility, goes to just over 300, which is not that bad. Yeah, but if you want to maximize the speed, then it does go all the way to just over 390, which is very notable. But keep in mind that because you're not maximizing the attack stat, you're not going to be hitting things as hard. But it does learn Hound Claws, which is useful for the most part, because that boosts the mediocre attack stat to a good level, and it also gives you a boost in accuracy as well. Substitute and Baton Pass are good because you can Baton Pass the substitutes, and of course the Hound Claws and agility boosts to go with it, and Spider Web. Now, what does Spider Web do? It basically traps your opponent and stops them from being able to switch. So in other words, it's like Mean Look. And of course, you can Baton Pass the effect of that across as well. And finally, Toxic Spikes, which is pretty good if you're running Ariados on a Trick Room team and you want Toxic Spike support. So that's pretty much all the boosts and notable uses you got for Heracross. Oh, beg your pardon, meant to say Ariados. My apologies. So most of the downsides are pretty much downsides I have already mentioned. The average base attack doesn't really help, but it does learn Hound Claws, so that does help things out. Its defense, special defense, I've already talked about. The speed isn't a big issue because of Trick Room, as always. And of course, all the physical moves are warded by steel types. So really, this is probably most of the reasons as to why Ariados is very rarely used for the most part. So yeah, you know, that's pretty much all I can say. So moving into the score now. The score for this Pokemon is a 5 out of 10. Now, it does do pretty well in what it does have to offer, but like a lot of Pokemon that are not used that much, it doesn't do everything right. It does a lot of things wrong. A lot of things haven't been done properly, or it's got too many downsides. So a 5 out of 10, I think, is just about right, if you ask me. So thanks a lot for watching. Look forward to another review next week. Again, if you have any requests, then by all means, send them in. I will try and get around to doing those screens eventually. Thanks a lot for watching. See you later.